dear students. In our previous class, we discussed about the Kodagu and Kittur. That we learned about the revolt of Amarasuriya and two outstanding sons of Kodagu. And in Kodagu, we also learned about the Rani Chennamma of Kitturu and Sangolli Rayanna. Right? In today's class, let us learn about the Tulu Nadu and Hyderabad of Karnataka. Now we will see Tulu Nadu. In ancient time, the part of coastal Karnataka was called Tulu Nadu. It comprised more or less the present Dakshina Kannada and Udupi district. In the Puranas, the western coast is called as Parashurama Kshetra. In the Puranas, the western coast is called as Parashurama Kshetra. Most people of Tulu Nadu speak Tulu language. Number of people also speak Kannada, Konkani and Bari language. Tulu Nadu was ruled by the Kadambas, Alupas, Hoysalas and the Vijayanagara and other small dynasties. The Alupa dynasty was ruled a long period. Udayanagara, Mangalore and Barakpur were the capitals of Tulu Nadu. Next, let us move on. British rule in Tulu Nadu. The British rule in coastal region commenced from the beginning of 8th century. The coastal region was called Kenara district. Later, Kenara district was divided into North Kenara and South Kenara. Next, let us move on freedom struggle. Inspired by Mahatma Gandhi, the people of Tulu Nadu actively participated in the freedom struggle. Famous among the freedom fighters, Karna Sadashivarao, Attavara Ellappa and Kudmam Rangarao. Called as the Desha Bhakto, Karna Sadashivarao rendered unforgettable service to the cause of the Harijans. He did a lot of help to the Harijans and he offered meals to the Harijan people in his home. And he sacrificed everything for the freedom of his motherland. And one more famous freedom fighter was Attavara Ellappa. He was a military officer for 15 years in Netaji's Indian National Army. He was a famous military officer in Netaji's Indian National Army. And one more famous freedom fighter was Kudmam Rangarao. He did a social reform movement for the upliftment of the Harijans. He actively worked for the education of Harijan girls. And in the field of banking, the record of Tulu Nadu is remarkable. Kenara Bank, Corporation Bank, Syndicate Bank, Karnataka Bank and Vijay Banks were established here prior to the attainment of independence. Thousands of branches of these banks spread over the length and breadth of the country have made a special contributions to India's economic growth, and they have also created thousands of job opportunities. These are the informations of Tulu Nadu. Next, let us move on Hyderabad, Karnataka. In that first, we will see rules of Beda Nayakas. What do you mean by Beda Nayakas? Here, Beda means hunters. Beda means hunters, and Kalavara means natives, and also use Nayakas as the last names. Now, Beda and Kalavara communities are identified as Nayakas. After the decline of Vijayanagara, the Beda Nayakas became dominant in Hyderabad, Karnataka. The brave warriors of the 1800, they revolted against the British for several times. Next, we will see the revolt of the Beda Nayakas of Kalagalli. The Arms Act passed by the British in 1857. The Arms Act passed by the British in 1857 had put a condition. What condition? The Indian could own army only with the prior permissions of the government. The brave and self-respecting Beda Nayakas could never accept such a condition. They are not ready to follow this condition. They impose the condition. So that time what happened? The British resorted to force. So that time some leaders who fought violently against the British. They were Jadaga, then Bala, Rami and others. 290 people taken captives and 19 were hanged. So this revolt was suppressed. It occupies a permanent place in the history of freedom struggle. Who was Rami? Rami was a violent beggar class woman. She actively participated in the revolt. But what happened? She was shot dead by the three British soldiers and become martyr. This is Sindhura Lakshmana. He was a remarkable leader who fought against the British. He was a remarkable leader who fought against the British. Sindhura means a village. It was under the firm hold of Inamdar. Inamdar is from Gaulas. Here, Sindhura Lakshmana openly challenged him. So, he became the enemy of the British. Here, Lakshmana was plundering the money from rich and the British treasure. What he did? He was distributed to the poor people and he was also helping the oppressed. Meanwhile, what happened? The village assembly accused him of robbery. Sindhura Lakshmana will be ever remembered in history of a revolutionary who passionately fought for freedom. Now, let us see the last concept of the Nayakas of Surapuram. Surapuram is a place, it is in Yadagiri district. Here, there was a settlement of the brave Beda Nayaka. Chirappa Nayaka, who came to the power? Veerappa Nayaka came to the power. That time, he was a boy of 8 years. That time, he was a boy of 8 years. Became his successor. He fought against the British and participated in the revolt of 1857. Finally, the British eventually captured Veerappa Nayaka and killed him. So, dear students, in today's class, we learned about the Tulu Nadu and Hyderabad of Karnataka. So now I am going to ask you questions. Just think the answer by yourself. Okay? Who was Sindhura Lakshmana? Sindhura Lakshmana was a remarkable leader who fought against the British. Who was Rami? Rami was a brave, valiant Beda Nayaka woman. In which district Surapuram was situated? Yes, of course. Yadagiri district. Surapura was situated in Yadagiri district. So dear students, read the lesson well and watch the video properly and understand it well. Thank you.